Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In this video, we'll be looking at how you can create pattern in Photoshop. For that, we'll be using these sketches to create a pattern. So the first step is to convert these as sketches into brush. And for that, we'll follow the same steps as we have seen in the first part of the tutorial. Just convert this into brush preset and create out a new brush. So we'll follow the same steps to create out all the four brushes. So here is the first brush, and we have created the other brushes as well. Here is our second brush, the third brush, and the light brush, that is the fourth brush. So we have got all our brushes ready. Now the first step to create out the pattern is, let's add a new layer, blank layer, and let's draw out a pattern. So for that, select the brush which you want to create, and then we'll do some adjustment in the settings. So open the brush settings, and first is shape dynamic, set it to 40% jitter, and angle jitter to 10%. And now let's apply it, and as you can see, we need some gap in between them. So under scattering, let's increase the scattering to 50%. And this will give this effect. We need more spacing, so I'll go there and let's increase the angle jitter. This will give some random effect in the angles, and we'll go to brush to tip shape, and here let's increase the spacing. Let's increase to 100, and now we got a distance, and that way let's create outer pattern. This is the look of the pattern which we are creating for our design, and let's create. I just filled up everything, and I'm making sure that I don't extend it out of the artboard. All the brush strokes are inside the artboard, and now we'll offset it. So let's adjust the horizontal, vertical, and make sure that the gap is like this in the middle, and then click OK. Now let's fill this area up. Just use the brush and draw out more brush in between. Just fill this up and make sure that you're not extending the brush outside the artboard. Everything should be inside it. And after this, we'll be converting it into pattern. So for that, let's go to edit and define pattern. So here we go. Let's give a pattern name and pencil pattern, and then click OK. And that way we have created a new pattern. To apply the pattern to our new surface, let's create a new layer. Let's fill this up with a solid color, alt backspace, and then double click on the layer, and over here activate pattern overlay. And here we go, let's go to pattern, and let's see where is our pattern. And here is our new pattern, it's there. And you can adjust the size, and you can even play with the opacity as well. And this is very like, you can use it in any design. Now you can even click and drag and move it, and you can see there's no edges wherever. Everything is seamless, continuous. So the first pattern is ready. In the same way, we'll create out the second brush pattern. For that, I'll choose the brush. Let's add a new layer. Let's hide out the layer and choose the brush. Let's go to brush and let's choose our new brush. This is the brush. Okay, now let's draw out a pattern using the brush. So I'm making sure that everything is like connected, and let's erase out this extended one, and then I'm duplicating everything over here and filling up the whole work area. But make sure that your ends are not extending out of the work area. That way you can give continuity effect, like seamless effect. So everything is inside the work area, and if you see something that's outside, just use the eraser tool and delete it out. And this is the very important step. Anything that you're preparing, it should be inside the artwork. And after that, once you're done, go to a filter, then other, and then offset, and we'll do the same settings over here. Horizontal and vertical adjusted, make sure that the gaps are in the middle, and once you're ready, just click OK, and then use the brush tool. But here let's erase out these incomplete brushes, and then let's add a new layer, and then draw out the brush, the new layers, because if you want to edit something, it will be in a new layer and I can edit it easily. So I'm filling up the whole area. And here we go. I'm deleting out the overlapping region using the eraser tool. And let's fill up the empty space as well. Now we'll convert it into pattern. Let's merge it. And now go to edit and define pattern. And let's give a name, pencil pattern number 2, and click OK. So the second pattern is also ready to apply it. Let's just open the pattern overlay effect and let's change the pattern to our new pattern, and it's there. And you can do the same effect here, scale the size and the opacity. And our next brush is different, so we'll be working on our third brush. For that, let's add a new layer and let's select our brush and let's scale down the size, go to settings, and here for this one I'm doing the same adjustment, 40 by 10, and let's apply it. Okay, we need some scattering as well, so let's increase the scattering to 50% and the brush spacing to around 100, and let's draw the pattern over here. I'm just drawing a random pattern, filling up the whole area with the brush sketch effect. It's very important to make sure that all the brushes are inside the artboard. Then apply offset, and in the empty region just fill up the brush, just draw it out, and then go to like edit and define pattern, give it a name and save it. And our third pattern is also created. Double click on pattern overlay and let's apply the new pattern. Here is our new pattern. Let's increase the opacity. Here is the pattern. So we are left with our fourth brush. We have created all of them. Let's follow the same steps to create out our fourth brush pattern. Just fill up the whole artboard, do the offset, then fill up the middle empty area, and after that go to edit, define brush and give it a name, and then click OK. Now if you go to pattern overlay, and you got our new brush as well. So this way you can create any pattern, you can use your any design. For this I have used my sketching brush, but you can create any other shape like vector or photo or anything, and you can convert them into brush, and after that you can use that brush to create our pattern like this. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates for designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.